Good morning and welcome to all parishioners from Knockinure and Moyvan parishes, and to all YouTubers who might be looking in this morning. My name is Maura Connolly and I live around the corner from this wall in Donnybrook. This is Eglinton Road, and every morning when I was going to work in RTE, a young man used to cycle up past me. Sometimes he'd smile, and one morning he jumped off his bike and he said, "I have an advantage over you. I know who you are, but you don't know who I am." I'm a student seminarian and I'm from Clare. And I said, recovering from my fright, I said, "Well, I've Clare connections too. My mother's from Clare." So then he said, "Will you give me 20 tickets for the Late Late Show audience for my fellow students?" And I said, "I can't give you 20 tickets, but I'll give you 4 and you can raffle them amongst the students." So that was 47 years ago, and I've been honoured and privileged to attend his ordination with my mother, his father, family and friends. And that was 39 years ago, yesterday, the 20th of June. That priest is my good friend, Father Kevin of Moyvan Parish. Back at my house now, as a newly ordained priest, en route to his ordination reception, he stopped off at St. Vincent's Hospital to give his mother, a patient there, his first blessing. And he also said his first mass there in his ward. Sadly, his mother died 4 days later after a long illness. Father Kevin's first requiem mass is for his mother in Coir Clare, County Clare. His dad treated him to a trip to Rome where he met Pope John Paul II, now a saint. His first assignment as a priest was to a very socially deprived area of Liverpool. All the presbytery windows were barred for security purposes. He had a mass congregation of 4 people. After 10 years of serving there, the congregation had increased to 784. During his Liverpool stay, he also led 3 pilgrimages to Lourdes with his parishioners. Also while in Liverpool, he was a journalist with the Catholic Victorian Weekly, where he had a page 3 full page headlined McNamara's Band, which was filled with interesting writings, including a 10-second sermon, which I thoroughly enjoyed reading every week. After Liverpool, he served in many parishes in Ireland up to his appointment as parish priest in Moyvan and Knockinure. He made exceedingly positive marks in every parish he served in. Through 47 years, Father Kevin has been a great friend to me and to my family. He officiated at many happy events. My husband Liam's, my beloved husband Liam's, and my marriage, as well as my brother's, nieces and nephews' marriages. He was there too for the sad times of my husband Liam's requiem mass, as well as for my father, mother and aunt's funerals. I am privileged to have had such a kind, loyal, true and trustworthy friend as Father Kevin for 47 years. So a little message for you today, Father Kevin. Congratulations on 39 years of priesthood, and I wish you good health, and as the good shepherd leading your flock, may you have many more years to come, please God. Finally, my commandment in life to me is, thou shalt be kind. Cherish your family and friends, and show them kindness, praise and appreciation whenever you can. God bless, and now over to Mass with Father Kevin in the Church of the Assumption, Moyvan.
I watch the sunrise, lighting the sky, casting its shadows near.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with your spirit. I'm smiling to myself because it's the first time that my great friend Maura, I've seen her operate in front of a camera. And secondly, I didn't anticipate that there would be a big surprise in it for me. As you know, yes, I'm celebrating 39 years of priesthood this week. So thank you very much, Maura, not only for the words, but for your great support and encouragement down through the years, and your family as well. They've always been terrific to me. So I'm just bowled over by, again, that lovely little tribute at the beginning. So I welcome all of you to this Mass today, and especially the Gruark family, Madge Gruark here in the village, who is absolutely tremendous, a woman of faith, and is heavily involved in our parish. It's the sixth anniversary of our loving husband, Jim Gruark, who was a sergeant here in the village. Left a lovely legacy. He died before I came to the parish, but he left a lovely legacy, and is always spoken with great affection by the people of my van and Knockanure for being a man of common sense. And certainly in days like we are encountering at the moment, it's common sense we need a lot more of. So for the legacy that Jim left, it's been fantastic, and a lovely family that he reared. And it is beautiful that Rita and Rachel will be providing the music for us today, and grandson Kevin Goulding, he'll be proclaiming the word of God to us. Keep an eye on that name wherever you are worldwide, because this man is a dab hand with the flick of the wrist and playing hurling and football. He's an all-round sportsman, and granddad would be proud of him today as he proclaimed the words of God to us. In welcoming you today, it's the readings, I think, are tailor-made for the 29th, which is the day that has been brought forward as the day when our churches reopen for Mass and the sacraments. The readings from Jeremiah and St. Paul, in particular, give us a choice not to be fearful, but to have a strong, firm faith and belief in the Lord. I pray that we will foster that belief now as we ask God to forgive us for our times of lack of faith as we pray. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. We still have the Sacred Heart here in the sanctuary. We leave him up just for the month of June. Our novena has concluded last Friday on the Feast of the Sacred Heart. So we had a great response and great prayerful time, and many rich blessings were received and celebrated through the power and intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. We're conscious as well that here in our own parish we have families that are grieving. Willie Buckley, who died suddenly, Church Road, just a few yards up from the church, died suddenly during the week, and his funeral was during the week. And Paddy Connolly in Glen, his funeral took place, and he has special relatives and friends in the parish here as well. So our prayerful support to them as we pray for Paddy and for Willie, and in particular today for Jim Gruark on the occasion of his anniversary. We're also conscious of all those on Madge's side of the family, the McKennas up north. We remember all of them, and for the Gruarks and for the McKennas, and in particular for Jim, whose anniversary it is. Eternal rest grant to them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive us of your guidance. Help us to be set firm on the foundation of your love. Be with the Gruark family at home and away today, as they honor Jim on the occasion of his 6th anniversary. We thank you for the blessings he created in home and family, but also for the rich legacy and goodness and kindness he shared with our community here. We pray that he will continue to reap the rewards of his labors, together with all the deceased in his family, the Gruick family, and all in Madge's side of the family, the McKenna family. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. From one Kevin to another, Kevin now Goulding will proclaim the first reading, and then the response will be sung, and then he will proclaim the second reading.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Jeremiah. He has delivered the soul of the needy from the hands of evil men. Jeremiah said, I hear so many disparaging me, terror from every side. Denounce him, let us denounce him. All those who used to be my friends watch for my downfall. Perhaps he will be seduced into error. Then we will master him and take our revenge. But the Lord is at my side, a mighty hero. My opponents will stumble, mastered, confounded by their failure. Everlasting, unforgettable disgrace will be theirs. But you, Lord of hosts, you who probe with justice, who scrutinize the lines and heart, let me see the vengeance you will take on them, for I have committed my cause to you. Sing to the Lord. Praise the Lord, for he has delivered the soul of the needy from the hands of evil men. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The gift considerably outweighed the fall. Sin entered the world through one man, and through sin death. And thus death has spread through the whole human race because everyone has sinned. Sin existed in the world long before the law was given. There was no law, and so no one could be accused of the sin of law breaking. Yet death reigned over all, from Adam to Moses, even though their sin, unlike that of Adam, was not a matter of breaking a law. Adam prefigured the one to come, but the gift itself considerably outweighed the fall. If it is certain that through one man's fall so many died, it is even more certain that divine grace coming through one man, Jesus Christ, came to so many as an abundant free gift. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The word was made flesh and lived among us. To all who did accept him, He gave power to become children of God.
Lord, I ask you to cleanse my heart and my lips, that I may joyfully proclaim your holy gospel. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus instructed the 12 as follows: Do not be afraid, for everything that is now covered will be uncovered, and everything now hidden will be made clear. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the daylight. What you hear in whispers, proclaim from the housetops. Do not be afraid of those who can kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Fear him rather who can destroy both body and soul in hell. Can you not buy two sparrows for a penny, and yet not one falls to the ground without your Father knowing? Why? Every hair on your head has been counted. So there is no need to be afraid. You are worth more than hundreds of sparrows. So if anyone declares himself for me in the presence of people, I will declare myself for them in the presence of my Father in heaven. But the one who disowns me in the presence of people, I too will disown them in the presence of my Father in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Some years ago, there's a story told of a group of teenagers who went to Mexico for one day to go down and help in a charity, Christian charity, little venture on the day. They were helping the poor and forgotten and the vulnerable. And they just mingled with them throughout the day, did little work for them, and to reassure them that these people were special. They worked very hard for the day, as only teenagers can. They really got into the spirit of it fantastically well. And they, when they got on the bus, they were tired, but they were equally hungry. Crossing into the United States, they stopped at a diner. And they went in and very kindly sat at so many tables. And they waited and waited and waited to be served. After a little while, one of the teenagers very politely went up to one of the waitresses and said, "We've a bus outside that is waiting. We've had a long, hard day down in Mexico doing some work, charitable work. We'd just like to be fed. When can we be served?" So she said, "Well, you know, we'll serve you, but the two black teenagers that are with you, those two will have to take their food onto the bus and eat in the bus." The teenagers looked at each other, and one stood up and finally said, "Well, we aren't hungry anyway, are we?" And they left politely and went back to the bus. What beautiful witness. And that even though that happened years and years ago, has things changed much in our modern day world of today? Jeremiah in the first reading, again, like that teenager that stood up and said, "We weren't hungry anyway," Jeremiah is the one who stood up in the first reading when he finds terror and upset at every side. He's living in a very fearful situation, but he stands up and he gives witness. He is not afraid. He holds his nerve, which is important. He's faithful because he feels that God is faithful to him. St. Paul in the second reading has the contrast between Jesus and Adam. Jesus is the one who brought grace and beauty and wonder into the world. Adam was the one that brought in sin, the clash that is there. And again, that's the constant clash that's in your heart and my heart. What do we bring? What do we bring to these days? Do we bring grace and blessings and patience, or do we bring just criticism? The gospel then, Jesus says, whoever is brave enough to stand up for me, I will stand up for them. But if you disown me, I'm afraid I'll have to disown you in the presence of my Father in heaven. It's a very strong claim that Jesus is making, but equally he is telling us that he will help us to give that good witness. The readings, I think, are tailor-made, as I said, for when we open the churches. We close the churches amid tremendous fear. We're opening the churches, again, amid tremendous fear. And Jesus is telling us, don't be afraid. He is with us, and he will guide us. And the one thing that we have learned in this parish is the basic little idea of common sense. We have the church open recently for private prayer. The courtesy, the kindness of people coming. No huge crowds. Everybody respecting and having reverence for what is there. Equally, when we open, I know that that common sense will prevail. The masses we've had from the porch here over the 9 days of the novena and for 2 weeks before that into the car park, people staying in their cars and the respectful way that they do that night in, night out. We can hold our nerve like Jeremiah. We need not to bring fear, but to bring the grace and power of God. May he bless us and may he help us to take his message today. Do not be fearful, do not be afraid. He is with us to guide and to bless us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father the Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We pray in the context of the first reading today, surrounded by terror and confusion, but he holds his nerve, the prophet Jeremiah. May he bless and inspire you and I not to be fearful in these days when we're about to open our churches for the Eucharist and for celebrations. I am aware that people are very conscious about returning to the churches. My advice is take your time. Come in your own time. And again here we're fortunate that in the car park we can still have the tannoy going for people who are maybe anxious about coming in at the very beginning. We pray, Lord, that you rid us of our fear and that we will trust in you and that you will guide us in the right ways in keeping us safe and well. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. The contrast between Jesus and Adam, Jesus bringing life and love and energy and bringing the presence of God, Adam bringing that selfishness, that which we're all prone to, that sin. We ask the Lord in the light of our experiences in the last while that our conversations, our words will be kind, uplifting and upbuilding our own communities and the people that are precious to us. Lord, hear us. In the light of the gospel, Jesus tells us how valuable we are. We pray that we will sense that value. But he also tells us, please be brave in declaring yourself for me, and I will lovingly declare myself for you in the presence of my Father in heaven. May we allow that blessing to guide us, and above all to give us encouragement in being the people that God has created us to be. Lord, hear us. Jim Groark, again, a great man of faith, himself and Madge, have reared a great family of faith, and they weren't afraid to profess that faith to their family. Their family are gifted both locally and right across the world where they're based and in other counties. We acknowledge all of them today, and I know you have special memories of Dad, who not only taught you the ways of life, but also led by example. May he continue to reap the rewards of his labors with the deceased in his own family and the deceased in the McKenna family, Madge's family. May they all be united and at rest in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. This coming week, each evening at 7:30, the porch mass door, we will be having for Mary Brosnan, Kyla Gorteen on Monday evening. On Tuesday, John O'Connor in Tarmans is honoring the anniversary of his brother Tommy O'Connor, Lochal and late of Tarmans. It's Tommy's anniversary. John wishes also to include his loving wife Helen O'Connor from Tarmans, whom he misses so much, and also to include the deceased of the O'Connor and Hanrahan families. Wednesday evening, we have an anniversary mass for our Nora Buckley, New York, and late of Bonnera. We pray in thanksgiving for Nora's generous life in the States and in Bonnera. We pray that she will continue to reap the rewards of her labors. On Thursday evening, we have the anniversary mass, for B.B. Dillon, Leitrim East. B.B. wasn't even 40, so we pray for Patrick, loving children and family at this time. That mass for B.B. Dillon, her Munce Mind, is Thursday evening. And Friday evening, Mike Joe Cronin, Mail Road Cross, his Munce Mind will be here. And we welcome Anya and Eileen and family to that. And then on Saturday, we'll be having the mass at the evening for the parishioners. So all those intentions will be included, plus your own prayers. And for all the faithful departed in the aforementioned, we pray, eternal rest grant to them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. I am not fearful of opening the church because I feel that people, again, the common sense, we all know about the social distancing, the way to use our hands, not to use our hands, keep washing our hands, all the million and one things we're to do. And I know that realistically that God will guide us in our beautiful church in reopening on the 29th. For the time being, we are taking it step by step, and then we will have more details at a later stage as to how we open Knockanure Church, which is much smaller, and how we can negotiate opening that for Sunday celebrations and for masses as well. We ask that the Lord will bless us in all the prayers that we have made today. And the final little prayer I'll make as we conclude the prayers of the faithful is a prayer to own your beauty. O God, help me to believe the truth about myself, no matter how beautiful it is. I ask you to believe that prayer today. And again, I thank Maura for her lovely greeting and blessings at the beginning of this Mass. It is deeply appreciated. And I pray that the Lord will continue to keep me faithful as his priest. We now have the offertory, and Rachel will play some beautiful music. And we will also get maybe a little glimpse of just a little postcard, little picture of the novena one night in the car park, just to see how it just operated during the offertory.
Tonight again, and just a reminder that tomorrow night that our theme is Okay, sector number 10 is not going, okay? Right, okay. 336, a yellow ticket, 33. Okay, that's okay, thank you. 471 to 475, yellow. 471 to 4.
Lord, wash away our iniquity and cleanse us from our faults and failings. You are a God of infinite mercy and compassion, Lord. We thank you for the graces and blessings you have bestowed on us. Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make an offering of a heart pleasing to you. Be with all the Gruach family today, Lord, in the memories that they have. As they join us through this YouTube Mass, reassure them that for Jim, life has changed, not ended. The influence that he created in their lives and in their hearts, in home and family, that influence is still there. May they celebrate it and enjoy it. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We've raised them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just. It is our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You are blessed, strong and faithful God. All your works, the heights and the depths, echo the silent music of your praise. In the beginning, your words summoned light. Night withdrew and creation dawned. As ages passed unseen, waters gathered on the face of the earth and life appeared. When the time at last had ripened, and the earth grown fully in abundance, you created in your image, man and woman, the crown of creation. You gave us breath and speech, that all the living might find a voice to sing your praise. Lord, you remind us that the gift of faith is so precious to us that we need to continually to nourish it, to guard it, and to protect it. For your faithful people like Jim Gruach, life is changed, not ended. When the body of our earthly dwelling goes to the grave, a new home awaits us in heaven. So for all whom we have prayed for today, who have gone to their eternal reward, may they pray in your presence for us, Lord, now and always, and may we joyfully acclaim our praise and love for you, acclaiming. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let your hearts be excited now as we come to the consecration. Jesus tells us, don't be fearful. Don't be fearful of what's around us or equally what is going on within you. Jesus is there. He can ease it if we invite him to those areas now. All holy God, how wonderful the works of your hands. You restored the beauty of the image when sin had scattered the world. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embraced the people as your own and filled them with longing for a peace that would last, for a justice that would never, never fail. Through countless generations, your people hungered for the bread of freedom. From them you raised up Jesus, the living bread, in whom the ancient hungers were satisfied. Jesus healed the sick, though he himself would suffer. He offered life to sinners, though death would hunt him down. But with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross and surrendered his spirit. Creator God, let your Holy Spirit move in power over us and over all earth gifts of this bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. On the very night he was betrayed, he met with death. He came to the table with those he loved. He took the bread, said the blessing, broke it, shared it with them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. He gave it to those at table. He said the blessing and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." My Lord and my God. Our mystery of faith. He's my forever friend, my leave me never friend, from darkest night to rainbow's end, Jesus is my friend. Creator God, we commemorate Jesus, your Son. As we offer you this sacrifice, death could not bind him, for you raised him up in the spirit of holiness and exalted him as Lord of creation. May his coming in glory find us watchful in prayer, strong in love, and faithful to the breaking of bread. Lord, on this Sunday, designated worldwide as Father's Day, we remember with love all dads. Those who are still living, we pray that they will be blessed on this day by being honored and respected by family members, and fussed in a special way today as well. We thank them for their vocation, we thank them for their inspiration, and for the example that they give us. And through sunshine and cloud, may all dads feel that presence of your love today in blessing them in their work. Like as in my own case, and in with the Kruerk family, Jim today, and all the dads that are in heaven, we ask that they will continually pray for us and cast a little warm blessing on us today. We thank them for the graces and blessings they shared with us, and may they rest in peace. Rejoicing in the Holy Spirit, your whole church offers thanks and praise. Together with Francis our Pope, Ray our Bishop, we pray for all watching in this morning, and all who are linked to us through Parish Radio Link, and all whose lives bring hope to this world. Lord of the living and the dead, awaken to undying light of pardon and peace those fallen asleep, especially in the hope of resurrection, especially Jim Kruerk, whom this Mass is being offered for today, and for all whom we prayed for earlier in this Mass. Gather them all into the company with Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. Then at last, with all creation, will be one, and all divisions healed, we shall join in singing your praises through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good and beautiful. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus is telling us today, either we are for him or against him. I most certainly are for him. I know you are as well. May we have a courageous way of trying to show it, and no better way than showing it in accepting and living out the values and the beautiful sentiments shared in Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Let us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Jesus, fill us with your love and inspiration as we prepare to open our churches. We close them before St. Patrick's Day and Holy Week in fear. Help us not to open them in fear. And again, not putting rules and regulations before people, but a conversation where we will continue to respect and give space to each other. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, it's with faith in your love and mercy we eat your body, we drink your blood. May it never bring us condemnation, but health of mind, body, and memory. Jesus, truly present here under bread and wine, the body and blood of Christ, I pray today that you will touch us and bless us in a way that gives us confidence, that gives us energy, that gives us a pep in our step to realize that every breath we take, every step we make, that you are with us. May you bless us in a way that only you can, that will give us life and give it in abundance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome, Lord Jesus, welcome. I am the good shepherd, and I lay down my life for my sheep, says the Lord. We'll now have our communion hymn. I'd like to thank Rita and Rachel and Kevin today for doing Jim's Mass justice in the singing ministry and in proclaiming the Word of God. It's lovely to see a young person proclaim the Word of God as well, and Granddad would be exceptionally proud of him today. So for the imprint that they put on their Father's Mass today, I know it's been a great strength, and again to those across the world who are watching, again our prayerful support to you today. Also, it's nice to have heard from Manchester during the week, from Annie Gallagher as well. We'll be on to her during the week again. She's just looking for some information on the cemeteries here, so that information will be coming through during the week. Thanks to all of you who have taken the time and the energy to engage with us each week. We, again, through the influence of Connor and his heart and imagination, we have tried to keep the masses kind of fresh, to keep, you know, just motivating ourselves to bring various aspects of the Word of God in a different way to you. And we hope that, again, they are touching all of us. They certainly have touched me deeply as well, you know, each Eucharist. And it's bringing us nearer that day when we're coming back to opening our churches again. And my prayer is that, please God, no matter what the world ever sends to us again, that we will never have a period or a time when our churches will be closed. Today, Father's Day, it was easy for me to pick the song for today. We had him here in this church. He packed the church, Phil Coulter, a concert some years ago. And the song that he has today is The Old Man. It's a lovely one. And those of you that have your dads, please tell them today you love them. And don't leave it too late. For those of us like myself, whose dad is in heaven, we can look back with gratitude as to the imprint they placed in our lives. Phil Coulter, The Old Man, with your cup of coffee after Mass. Until we meet next Sunday, for our final YouTube Mass, again, we'll have something special for you on that day. Until we meet again, let's continue to keep each other in our prayers. The Lord be with you. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To those in Dublin, again, all who helped, Glenn, who helped Maura with the sending on the beautiful message at the beginning of Mass, to the Grorks here, and to Connor, and to all who helped, and Noreen in particular, for all the beautiful way she has the flowers arranged here continually for all our celebrations. They are delightful, and the side altars as well. So to her in particular as well, Mila Buikas, and thank you, Noreen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit, and may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us be at peace with God and with each other. Thanks be to God.
May the road arise to meet you. May the wind be at your back. May the sun